गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम अगेन द सेवेंथ पार्ट ऑफ HTML. इफ यू हैव गॉन थ्रू 1 to 6 पार्ट ऑफ HTML, यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस वन ऑल्सो एंड दिस इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग्स. दिस फोर थिंग्स टुडे आई विल टॉक अबाउट द टेबल टैग. टेबल ऑलरेडी यू हैव सीन इन द एक्सेल वर्कशीट व्हेनेवर यू हैव वर्क्ड इन एक्सेल. इन टेबल व्हाट इट कंटेन्स, टेबल कंटेन्स रो एंड कॉलम where we put our data. Okay, so today I will talk about this table tag, how to create a table in a website. Okay, first of all, it is just like an Excel sheet, because another thing made up of row and column, no doubt. Third one, how to write this table tag in angular bracket. Under that you will write simply table, and it is a container tag, means it once it's open it must be closed. Okay, now table tag having two helping tags, because we have to create row and column. Okay, for row, for creating row, we have this tr and an angle bracket. This tr represent that you are going to make a row for the table. Okay, so this tag create row. Another is how to create column. Column we have td under angular bracket, it helps to create column inside the table. Okay, then another thing, another tag we have, and these all are container tag, means once you open you have to close. And another tag we have th. This th means table heading. What is table heading? Let me explain a little bit. Suppose you want a display like this. You write your name, roll number, tell where you found your name. Okay, suppose one, I told you that create one data sheet or create one table in HTML where the heading of that particular table is mentioned here. First heading is name, second heading is roll number, her heading is father's name. This is heading. Okay, that is th. So th is a container tag also, and once you open you have to close this th. Now some attributes I will talk about this table tag, which we will use in the letters, not today. Today I will tell you just how to create a simple table in a website, but you should know these all things also. What are the attributes of table tag? Number one, border. Border means the line which you are looking here outside this table, this is known as border of that table. So thickness or the width, whatever the thickness or width you want for that table, you can decide those things by using this border attribute with table tag. Suppose you want this outline to be a little bolder than the rest which is inside. Okay, so you can make through this border attribute of table tag. Another is cell padding. What is cell padding? Cell padding means distance between cell border and content. Content means what? Suppose roll number I have written 1, here I have written 2. Name A, name B, father's name X, father's name Y. Suppose you have written like this. So what is cell padding? Cell padding decides the distance between the cell border and content. What is content? Content. This is content. Okay, this A, B, 1, 2, X, Y is content. And the distance means this wall, this particular column, the intersection of row and column, this particular section where our content should display from the border, from the border of that particular cell. So this cell padding, we can also use this cell padding to decide where we should put our content in a cell. Why? To make your table beautiful, simple. Another thing is cell spacing. Here you have cell spacing. Cell spacing says the width of the border. It also this is the width. Okay, what the means you want, you can set it at per your requirement by using this cell spacing attribute of table. Another thing is call span, the sum of the attribute used in table or td tag, used with table or td tag is call span, column span you can say, or row span you can say. What is column span? Suppose you need, while creating a table, you need that cell, if these two particular column get merged into one, because the name which I am entering here is too bigger. So I want to merge these two cells together. For that, we will use this column span. Okay? And suppose if you want to merge two rows together, suppose this row and this row you want to merge together like this, and this will be having two columns, but this one will be a single column. Okay, this one will create a single column by merging the column and the row together. For that we need this row span. So column span works when we merge, when we want to merge two columns together, two or more columns together, and row span works when we want to merge two rows or more than two rows together. Clear? Okay, now a simple example I'll give you. This is okay. You can, by passing your screen, you can note down this one at your home in your fair copy. Okay, now one example I'm going to okay, first display page, the website display page. Your web browser, what you will do? So you want a display, something you have written, right? Okay, so write your table. open, you are opening of the tab. Now another thing was tr to create a row and tv to create a column. So we will write here tr. Once you tr is created, you have to create the same thing. Another, just add one more thing. You want the border, border you have here in the display. So with the table you will use this border attribute. Border suppose equal to the value will must be 1 to 5. Any number you can use. I am using here 2. Okay, close it. And we start the row section. Tia. Okay, one row I'm going to create. Your first row, what you found find here? Name, role, class, and father's name. So you will, and these all are table heading. So you will use here TH. Start TH. Okay. Table heading. Number one is name. Write your name. Then close TH. Number two. Again TH. That is raw. Close TH. Number three. Again table heading. Class. Close this TH. Number four. TH. Then again we have father's name. Father's name. Then close this TH. Now this particular section you have covered, table heading you have covered. So this row, this particular TR will be closed here. So you will close TR. Okay. This section is created. You have right until now. I have created just the first section. Now again you will write this TR. Okay. Now contents you want to put inside the column. So you will put here TD. And first one was the name here. A name was A. Close this TD. Then TD. Name was B. Close TD. Third TD. Name was C. Close TD. Keep on. Number of three columns here. You have to add this TD up to that number of times. Then TD. D. TD. Now the TR is at the second. Portion is over, so you will close this TR again. Close. Then again start TR for the second row. Second row was containing your roll number. Put here 1. Close this TR. And keep on going with this TR until you reach to TR. Sorry. Not TR, this is TD. Column you are entering. Now until you reach number 4, then close again TD, then close this TR. Okay. And in the last, what we will do, you will close this body and you will close this. Close this steel. After doing this, when you run and save this one with the .html extension, you will find you have reached that particular display which you have wanted. Okay. So today it's all about table, tags, and the attribute section I will discuss tomorrow. Till then, goodbye. ये बहुत लंबा हो